sleep on the bed. However, also I wanted to let him feel just like, you know, 15 years ago I was there and I was with Alec and I communicated with him a lot. We were friends and whenever I visit your house for the personal class, then we chat a lot and we watched, you know, the American soap opera friend together. So the kind of feeling I wanted to let him have that feeling again. Then even though his physical pain is still existing, however emotionally I want him to, you know, how can I say, feel better, yeah. And we are human beings, so I'm also getting older, and he is also getting older, and there is no person who can live forever. However, we are Christian. I'm a Christian, so I want him to, I want him to live peacefully here, and also I pray for him to God.
Oh, good. Prayers are always good. I pray for him too.
This last thing I want to share is my mother and father also, they are in their 70s, and sometimes like I go to, you know, my friend's parents' funeral, I feel very very bad and very sad, and but now this year I am 42 years old, and
still baby.
So what I mean is, I a little bit admit someday my parents might go to heaven. It's very hard for me to admit and accept the fact. However, one day my parents went to somewhere. That place is after funeral, I don't know the English term, but after not graveyard, and there is a place, and we can put let me explain. After like someone is dead, then we kind of burn the dead body, and then we have,
they say cremate.
Cremate.
Yeah, that's the word in English. Cremate. Burn the body.
Right. Thank you.
Crematorium.
Cremate. So after cremating, we have, you know, something in our hand, and
like a jar or something.
Right.
Yes.
Right. So we can put the jar in that place, very large place and peaceful place, by Christian owner. And my parents went there, and they registered their place there, and they let my sister and I know that, and it was sad.
Yes, well, yeah, it is sort of
right,
but yeah, it just sort of brings home the fact that that might be their next step.